Hey everybody, if you are having trouble hitting your macros, watch this video. So, just really quick, in general, macros, all it means is your protein, carbs, and fat. So, one of the things that people have trouble with when they're hitting their macros seems to be protein. Usually that's the number where people get screwed up. So they may hit it calorically, and they almost always have no trouble hitting fat and carbs. Protein seems to be the hardest one to hit. So what I've learned over the years to simplify things is you always, always, always start out with protein first, then you add your carbs, then fat almost inevitably takes care of itself, and then you add that on at the end, okay? So I'm gonna give you a quick example. We're gonna use some really broad numbers, and we're gonna divide this across four. So the first thing you wanna do is when you receive your macros, you wanna figure out for yourself, how many meals a day am I gonna eat? So there still has to be some planning. Maybe the worst thing you can do is wake up in the morning, go get breakfast or make breakfast, not really have a plan for the rest of the day, put those macros into your calculator, and then figure out how much you have left to eat. That is a recipe for disaster. So still has to be some planning on your part. Now, to simplify things, I'm gonna use four meals. Five or six meals seems to be the best in the fitness community. However, that doesn't mean that fits your lifestyle. So this has to be personal preference, what's gonna work for you. You with me? So again, four meals, we're gonna take our macros. So if you wanna take a look at this board, I've written some really broad numbers, right? So we're gonna start with protein. Protein, we're gonna get 200 grams. We're gonna divide that across four meals. So that's gonna give me 50 grams of protein. Carbs, you're gonna get 150 divided by four, 37.5. And then fat, you get 12.5 grams per meal. So again, we're gonna leave fat out of the equation for now to simplify this. So the first thing you wanna do is figure out how much protein am I gonna need? So how many ounces of protein am I gonna need to get 50 grams of protein? Sorry, how many ounces of protein am I gonna need to hit 50 grams, right? Now, from there, hypothetically, we're gonna take another broad example. Let's say you need chicken. So if you need chicken, you probably need, in this case, 8 ounces of chicken. So the next thought should be, what am I gonna eat with my chicken? If you're gonna eat potatoes, if you're gonna eat white rice, if you're gonna eat brown rice, if you're gonna eat quinoa, you have to factor that in. Again, you need to plan. So how many ounces am I gonna need of, say, white rice to hit 37.5 grams of carbs? So figure that out. If it's 4, 4.5, 5 ounces, there you go. Then your fat, you can do like Kelsey does and leave those for the end, right? So if you plan this out and you see, this is how many ounces of protein I need, here's how many ounces of carbs I need, how much fat is left? So if you had 50 grams and you went through your day and you kept it extremely simple, which is another thing I recommend, especially in the beginning, keep your meals as simple as possible. Don't fall into the trap of, but I thought this was more flexible. It is flexible, but the numbers that you get, those are just max numbers, and those will undoubtedly have to change. They're gonna change over time with how you progress, your goals, that's all contingent. So don't worry if your number is 1600 calories, hitting that number, the first thing you gotta do is just try to get in the amount of food that you're comfortable with, and then you can start to adjust. But you have to have some consistency in order for you to adjust. So if you have 2000 calories one day, and you have 1400 another day, you have 1100 another day, and then 1500 another day, you haven't really had any consistency. So at the end of the week or 2 weeks, you're not really gonna know what is the right number. So again, my recommendation, keep it as simple as possible, especially in the first 2 to 3 weeks, so that you make sure you understand whether this works or not. So if you're losing too much weight, okay, so I have to bump up some numbers. If I've lost just the right amount of weight, cool, these numbers work for me. Hopefully that makes sense. So again, you've simplified this, so I'm moving back to fat, because that's the number that everybody doesn't have a problem hitting. So I'm gonna use Kelsey as an example. She likes avocado and she likes it at her last meal. So theoretically, let's say she gets 50 grams of fat, and through her first 3 meals, she's already had 40. So that leaves her 10 grams of fat, right? however much fat is in that last meal. Let's say it just has 2 grams of fat. So she has 8. So now she has to do is figure out how many ounces or what weighted amount of avocado she needs to hit. I'm sorry, not to hit, but how many she's gonna be able to have in order to not max out her macros. Hopefully that makes sense. So again, you may be a breakfast person and you love whole eggs. So you might use up the majority of your fat macros at breakfast, or maybe you're a lunch person. Again, if you don't plan, you don't know. Do not eat your first two meals. Don't go to breakfast, go to lunch, put it in, and then try to figure it out. You have to have some planning done, especially in these first few weeks, so then you can make adjustments, right? First few weeks, gotta make adjustments. Changes are inevitable, so you have to have some consistency. Any other questions? Nothing you can think of? If you guys have any additional questions, please post that, drop it. I'll try to answer those questions. If you know somebody that might benefit from this video or do you think needs help, tag them in it so that they can get a better understanding. Thank you for watching.